this is a cool transition. And this is my favorite in-camera transition because you don't really...
I don't know how to do transitions.
Man, I hate transitions. They're cheap, lazy, and how many times have we seen a whip pan transition on YouTube or one of those? It seems like people have lost their ability to make straight cuts and think about their edit as a whole. They only use transitions as crutches. And that's just poor storytelling. It seems like there's no other way to make a video nowadays. Sure, it might be great for social media, where you need to engage your audience in several seconds, but what happens if you use the wrong transition at the wrong time? Like, where did that come from? Transitions should enhance the story, not become the story. And when overused, they are annoying. And when overused, it would be like riding on a roller coaster sitting in a library. Well, I'm not saying all transitions are bad. For example, fades, wipes, dip to black, whip pan, J-cut, L-cut, match cut, film burn, keying, or cigarette burn. All of these have their own place. Well, that didn't work, or did it? But let's not sacrifice working on the message for the sake of views. So the next time you're tempted to throw in a whip pan transition on your video, ask yourself, am I making my video better, or am I just using this to repair my headphones? All right, so let's get right into the edit. The first transition is really pretty simple. It is the underlining concept of every single transition that is out there. So listen up. It's pretty simple. If you have your camera, probably it's going to be your phone. If you end one shot on this, your next shot should start like this. So if you spin to the left, you should start your next shot by spinning to the left. It's super simple. Basically, you are making a cut where it's all blurry, so nobody's gonna know. Nobody's gonna know. It looks something like this. You just go through, you whip it, you cut here when it's just blurry, and you got yourself a clean transition. Pretty simple, pretty easy. The next one is the second principle, pretty much, or the second way you could do everything. So it is just dip to black. It's so simple. Also, if you just have your last frame of the shot black and start with a black frame with some kind of a movement, it aligns. And the only thing you need to be aware of is that the movements really kind of match to each other. If they don't, it can be kind of jarring. But usually what works is really just into the camera and out of the camera. It's super, super simple. And this is how I did it. I just slapped the camera like so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 10, 10. Bang, full black frame. That's already the cut. I make sure I cover the whole lens, the whole field of view with the box, so it's pretty simple. And then I just take it out. I repeat it with the next one by simply covering the whole thing. It takes a lot of takes to get this right. And then I open a doctor's bag that I didn't show before, but it is what it is. I kind of like how it frames me. It looks pretty cool. And it's pretty much the same principle. You end with black, you start with black, you can do whatever you want. So if someone is saying, hey, I got this next transition, what next transition? There are pretty much two or three concepts that you recycle over and over. And if you do a spin, a whip pan, a tilt up and down, I don't really care. It's all pretty much the same transition. So yeah. The next type is the ones made in post-production. Those are pretty easy. You can get them on any site like Artlist, Envato, Shutterstock, I think also. I got these from Envato. On Windows, you'll import them in the file path I'll show you right here. and then they show up in effects, in video transitions, and then you can really put anything you want in here. Let me just delete this so you can see I put something on it. And they render really slow. So, yeah. So that's pretty simple. And I put a little sound effect in, like this.
The wrong time. Like, where did that come?
So, yeah, that did not play smoothly, but you get the idea. The next two transitions are more of the same. There's a spinny transition. I try to find one that is really annoying just to drive the point home. And then the typical thing is a zoom punch transition, which can work sometimes if you really want to get from wide shot into something more detailed. Maybe I could have used this to get to the headphones that I'm soldering. And the last one is when you cover up the frame with your phone and end up somewhere else. Okay, in this instance, I did it a little differently. I chose a match cut type of scenario, and I left half on purpose and half not on purpose, a little mistaken. And that is when I take the notebook up, I pretty much do something like this. I do one take like that, and the other one, I flip it and show it from the other side, which really is not ideal, but it still kind of works because if you go frame by frame, you can see that you continue the transition there. So basically, if the phone over here would be doing something like this, boom, 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 boom. So you would cut somewhere like boom, boom here. And then the next shot would start where you anticipate the movement is in the next frame. If the movement is bigger, the jump is bigger, and then the transition is not as successful. However, it's really super, super easy. You can also do it with masking, animate the mask, show something different. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This video was kind of hard to make, so please drop a like. It took way more time than I thought it would. I did a lot of lighting in this one, so if you want the next tutorial to be about lighting, I have a lot of behind the scenes from this. So please drop a comment, subscribe, and see you in the next video.